do 5 minutes.
And welcome, everybody. It is National Mutt Day, and we are excited to be here. We'll throw a little theme music into this today, right? Make it sound a little more exciting here. So anyway, we have special guests. Sally Olson, Ned Mills will be joining us. We have Lola, the Chihuahua. Maybe not quite a mutt, but close. Lola is a dog, of course. So Lola will be joining us as well. Excited to have everybody here today. We will be giving away this Fire TV Cube. One lucky person today will be taking this home with them. It's about $150 value. You love to stream things to your television. This is the ultimate way to do that. So we'll be giving this away. I have a feeling that we might even be able to stream Sally and Ned's Carpenters Christmas tribute to this, or with this, for your television. So anyway, so excited to be here today, everybody. It is National Mutt Day, and we're just going to get right into it. So my name is Marlo Anderson, founder of National Day Calendar, coming to you live from the world headquarters of National Day Calendar, where we celebrate every day. And I'm happy to introduce to everybody Sally Olson, Ned Mills. Excited to have you on the show.
Hey. Hi. Thanks for having us.
How are you?
I'm doing well. So you two actually kind of look like the Carpenters. Have you heard that before?
Yeah. I mean, as you know, as tribute artists, we're the type of tribute artists who are impersonators. So in our case, yes, it's very helpful to look the part as well.
Yes. So I'm going to play one clip right away, everybody, so you can see who Sally and Ned are and the amazing job that they do. If you're Carpenters fans, you're going to love this. So I know you have a Christmas tribute that you're doing right now. So I have a couple of just short tracks. So I'm just going to play one right away so everybody understands who we're talking to here. So here we go.
Merry Christmas, darling. That's true, but I can dream, and in my dreams, I'm Christmasing with you.
Absolutely wonderful. Absolutely wonderful. So how did you get into, you know, what, I'm trying to think of the best way to say this, but what inspired you to do a tribute based around the Carpenters?
For me, it's kind of an interesting story. I fell into the tribute artist genre, kind of, it was a happy accident through the back door type of a thing. I had been training professionally as a singer since 2010. And I'm actually from Vermont, although I live in Las Vegas now. I've only been here for about 2.5 years. And back in about 2014, while I was training professionally, and I was also a managing director at a voice studio back in Vermont, in Burlington. And I was at the point where I wanted to put together a one-woman show. And at the time, I didn't really have a specific focus. It was just going to be an opportunity for me to kind of have this debut performance. And the original idea is that was that it would be just a bunch of different songs that I liked. And then at one point I started reading through music and read through the Carpenters music, which I'd always been familiar with because ever since I was pretty young, like in high school, I was drawn primarily to the music of the 60s and 70s. So I read through the Carpenters music as I was preparing for this one woman show. And it was kind of an aha moment, and it was a perfect fit vocally. And then as I kind of delved more into researching about Karen's personal life, it was even a really good fit for me, because I just really have a lot of admiration and respect for her, not only as a performer, but you know, as a person. She was just a really unique and special person. So I just, all of a sudden, I decided that my show would be a tribute to Karen and the music of the Carpenters. So I started performing as Karen Carpenter in 2015 and was doing it solo in terms of, I didn't have a pianist who was also playing the role of Richard. But then a couple years went by and the show developed and I realized that I wanted to have somebody playing the role of Richard. I had several people for me to go out to Las Vegas and audition for Legends in Concert, which I did. And now I perform with them as their first ever Karen Carpenter.
Very cool.
During that first trip, I met Ned and he was interested in the idea of playing Richard and things just developed. And now we're doing what we do.
And the rest is history.
Yeah.
So I'm going to get into your story in just a second, Ned, but we like to give everybody a chance to win a prize, and we actually give people three chances to do this, by the way. Wow. So I'm going to run this across the bottom. It's going to be a little different today, everybody. You're not going to be guessing a number between 1 and 10,000. We want you to post your favorite dog name. So if you were to get a mutt today, what would you name your new mutt? And we're actually going to have Google choose this name for us at the end of the broadcast. You're going to get three chances. So starting right now, you can actually start guessing or putting in your choice for your name for your new mutt. What would you name your new mutt if you had a new mutt today? And so go ahead and start that, everybody. You're going to get three chances. So chance number one is right now. And while people are picking that, Ned, I want you to talk about your choice for getting involved here.
Yeah, well, it kind of picks up where Sally left off when she visited Las Vegas. I was performing at a casino here in Las Vegas, hotel casino, and a mutual friend of ours invited her to say, hey, I have all these musician friends that would love to accompany you, meet you if you want to sit in. And so she sat in on one of my gigs, as we call it, right? And we clicked right away. And I wasn't that familiar with the Carpenters, much more than a regular, you know, layman's knowledge of it.
Sure.
We all know the greatest hits, of course. But once we dug into it and I was like, maybe I could see myself doing the role of Richard. I have played other roles. I've played the role of Jerry Lee Lewis in the show before. And
oh, really?
I do a few character voices. I do Louis Armstrong and Sarah Vaughan and a couple of crazy things that your viewers are probably too young to know who they are.
Well, I don't know about that, but you know, I have, you know, I'm sure you're going to be shocked by this, but I have a clip of you. So let's see here. See if I can find it quickly here. There we go. So a multi-talented Ned.
Make it easy on yourself.
I'm playing the role of Herb Alpert there. In fact, we do that in our main show, Carpenters Tribute Concert, not the Christmas show. In the Christmas show, I play the role of Richard all the way through the show. But a lot of people have asked us, why do we do that? Because they forget that the A of A&M Records, Carpenters label, was Herb Alpert.
Yes.
And he gave them their big break. So we thought that would really be a nice, refreshing change of pace and opening act. So I open for myself, and so I do 15 minutes, and I explain the connection. We do Tijuana Taxi, as you heard, Taste of Honey, Lonely Bull, and between each song, I explain the connection between A&M Records and the Carpenters.
Of course, Herb Alpert was instrumental in bringing a lot of artists forward. I remember I'm trying to remember the name of the song that Janet. Her very first song, Janet Jackson and Herb Alpert. I'm going to look that up. But that actually is the first time we ever heard Janet Jackson was on her, Herb Elbert song as well.
Tennille is another one, and Carole King.
Yes.
Major artists. They were the largest, at the time, the largest independent record label in the world.
Amazing. So, all right, everybody, on the first time, we're going to give everybody 15 more seconds. If you haven't got your name in yet, or for your dog, if you got a new mutt today, what would you name your new mutt? And one of you are going to actually win this Fire TV cube. And, I love it. And your first chance is now closed.
Daddy, come back. Okay.
And let's see. Oh, and Angela got in right before the end. Toto is what she would name her new mutt. So, all right. So now you guys have put together a Christmas tribute. Why don't you tell us a little bit about that?
Sure. Well, as you know, the Carpenters had so many great and wonderful hits. And for a lot of people, the Carpenters are synonymous with Christmas music. So it's just kind of a given that if we're doing a Carpenters tribute, we also have to have a Carpenters Christmas show. So the only tricky thing with that is that the Carpenters never really toured with their Christmas music. So to put the Christmas show together, and because we're very big on authenticity, we kind of had to think, what would the Carpenters have done if they did concerts with their Christmas show?
Okay.
And for a lot of people, they when they think about the Carpenters and Christmas, they remember their two big Christmas TV specials. They did one in 1977 and one in 1978. So our show is modeled off of their Christmas TV specials.
Very cool. So in about another minute, everybody, you're going to get your second chance to win the Fire TV Cube. I'm going to actually, I have a couple more clips here. So here's Christmas clip number two.
Just hear those sleigh bells jingling, ring, ting, tingling too. Come on, it's lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with you.
So there we go. They're nice and short and sweet, of course, but we just want to tease everybody a little bit here, right? So are these little snippets that we're playing here, are they part of the show if people were to go watch it?
Absolutely.
Oh, yeah.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. I'm losing my hat, as you can tell. The spring is like, you know, I keep going like this and it slides off to the side. So,
by the way, Dr. Seuss called. He wants his hat back.
You have no idea how hard it was for me to get this from him. So, of course, I have a little bit of a photo shoot after this. So my one hair that's left is going to be all over the place after wearing this thing. So, all right. So everybody, we're going to open it back up again. If you're wanting to give us another name for, if you got a new mutt today, because we're celebrating National Mutt Day, we want you to put that name in, post your name. And if Google picks the name that you chose, you're going to win this Fire TV Cube. So, how it works. Go ahead and put that in there. And Lola.
Hi. she got caught in her sweater. Hold on a second.
Okay.
We have a wardrobe malfunction.
Yeah. Uh-oh. There she goes.
Kind of Janet Jackson, right?
Yeah. Say hi. She's a little shy today. What's up with that?
She's so tiny that we have to get her like extra, extra small. And sometimes those are still too big for her.
Sure. So how old is she?
Yeah.
She's
today's her birthday.
5 months old.
5 months old today.
Very nice. So why a chihuahua? Chihuahua.
Well, I had a chihuahua who is actually, she's 12 years old and she lives with my grandparents back in Vermont. So I've kind of been attached to that breed for quite a while. And we were visiting my family back in Vermont in June and they have pugs too. And I was like, oh, I really miss having a little dog. And so started looking again. And there's a lot of chihuahuas in the Las Vegas area who need homes. So,
okay. Very nice.
And so I'm a Barbara, care person.
Barbara she just commented here. I don't know if you see that or not. Her current dog's name is Lola.
Oh,
so there you go.
It's actually a really popular dog name. And I had no idea.
Okay. So. I would have never guessed that either.
Yeah.
And I'm a cat person. Sally had to talk me into it. Let's get a dog. I'm like, well, I don't know. In about 2 days, she became daddy's little girl. No,
okay. There you go. So Angela posted Chihuahuas are great. I like that. I mispronounced that earlier. Chihuahua, right? That's actually kind of a cool thing. Chihuahua, right?
Yeah.
She has two heifer and squirrel. Yes. Yes. Very cool. Yeah. Share your cute dog's names. Oh, yeah. People, please share your dog's names. Let's get them in there. Let's win this. Somebody's got to win this Fire TV cube. So Barbara's stating that.
Mutt Day.
But I think, pretty much any dog, well, I won't say any dog would qualify as that. I'm a mutt. I don't know about you guys. Are you 100% of anything, or are you kind of mixed as well?
We're mutts, too. French and
Swedish. All French on my mom's side. Then my dad's side is Swedish, hence Olson.
Okay.
And some Russian and Czech. So, yes.
Oh, wow.
I prefer cash. But I'm English, German, Scotch, Irish. But I think the Mutt Day thing is a great concept. Whether it's a mutt or purebred or whatever, I think it is important if you have the option, you're considering a pet, to adopt a pet.
Absolutely.
Lola is a rescue pet. Her mother was found abandoned under a porch, pregnant with her and her two brothers. And so we found them through Wagging Tails Rescue in Las Vegas.
Yep.
And we adopted her. She was almost pure white when we got her, and her spots started growing in. Well, she's got a sweater on now, but see all these spots.
Very nice.
Yeah.
Very December is there's an operation called Santa Paws, PAWS, a national effort over the month of December to help rescue animals as well. So look for that as well. If you're looking to adopt another family member, that's a great way to go too. So Charlene states we have a mutt. She is awesome. That's fantastic. Oh, and we have some smart Alex in the room that thinks that they should name their mutt Marlo. Yeah. I guess over the next couple months now, if there's a lot of dogs by my name, now we'll know what went on there. So, all right. Well, let's get it going again, everybody. Let's we're gonna finish up this segment of chance number two to win the Fire TV Cube. This wonderful little guy right here. So we'll give it another 15 seconds and we'll close that up. And I have to make a special announcement too today. You guys, nobody knows about these things yet because they're not actually out. Should have probably posted it on there. I don't know if you can see that well. This is our new Christmas ornament. Celebrate every day right on there. These are actually 3D printed and hand painted.
Wow.
So they're kind of a cool little thing. We only have 500 of these. It's a limited edition type of thing. So anybody's interested, you can actually go to the National Day Calendar store and check out the Celebrate Everyday ornament. I didn't check to see how much these things are, but I know they're not very expensive. They're, I think, under $10. They're probably right at $10 when I say that. But or maybe they're $15. I don't know. Maybe we could be charging $30 for these, and then we throw in a concert ticket. For you guys, right? We should do that, actually. That's a good idea.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Let's talk about that after this.
Sure.
So, all right. So we're going to close that up. So I'll put in close round two. And so how do we watch your tribute concert?
Sure. So our Christmas show, which we debuted this past Saturday, and it was live streamed, but now they captured it and it will be available on demand, I believe, through the end of the year. Mm-hmm. On WALE Rocks. So you go to WALE.rocks.
I will put that across the bottom here right now.
And then
WALE means we are live entertainment.
Yes.
And then it's WALE.rocks. I think it's /carpenters-bio, and that will bring you to the show event page. And then you can just purchase your on-demand pass, and you're all set to watch it whenever you want.
And does the pass last for like a 24-hour period, or do they have access to the show for 30 days, or how does that work?
That I'm not actually sure.
I'm sorry.
Okay.
We can't wait to see it, too. We just filmed it on
I'm sure it says it. I bet it, when you go through the process, it probably tells you how long you've got it for.
Sure. I don't mean to put you guys on the spot. I should have asked that with George or whatever beforehand, too. But yeah, and we can play one more. I have another little snippet here of the Christmas.
And so I'm offering this simple phrase to kids from 1 to 92. Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas to you.
You guys really are amazing.
Oh, thank you.
And I really am. I'm a huge Carpenters fan, and I just think that you guys have done just an amazing job. Really have. So, okay. So we're getting, here's the link right here, Carpenters bio. So you can hop on over there and take a look at it. I also got notice from Michelle that the ornaments are $6.99. Just $6.99, everybody, for a limited edition. So that's kind of cool. Sophie, she's loving that green jumpsuit, Sally.
Oh, thank you. Well, it's all of our costumes are that both Ned and I wear are exact replicas of the things that Richard and Karen wear.
Very cool. So is there a story behind the teddy bear that you were holding?
Yeah, so in their 1977 Christmas television special, while Karen is singing the Christmas song, as you saw me singing there, and also wearing that green jumpsuit, she had a koala teddy bear. If that's what you would call it.
Well, koala. We wouldn't say bear. Yeah.
But it is a
Australians.
Teddy, but it's like a teddy bear.
Yeah.
Koala.
It's a koala.
yeah. So yeah, that was she loves stuffed animals, and that was one of her favorite ones. And so that was featured in the television special during that song. So I try to recreate all those little special moments, and especially all those little references that Carpenters super fans would get.
And we had a lot of fun during our rehearsals too, because we rehearsed most of the music right here at home. I'm the arranger of all the music for the show. And we had a fun moment where we don't have it right now, but Sally had made some custom little reindeer antlers for Lola. And then during the show, we did see if reindeer really know how to fly. And then we had her like flying through the,
very cool. All right, we're gonna run the last round now of you have to tell us if you were to get a new mutt today, because we are celebrating National Mutt Day. What would you name your new mutt? So
music, right? Ready?
Yes, get the music going here. There we go. Go ahead and start guessing, everybody. We're putting your names in there. Maybe have a favorite name that you haven't posted yet. Go ahead. This is round three for a chance to win this amazing Fire TV cube. Thank you for that, Ned.
Yeah. You're welcome. Oh, hi, George. George is George.
So, yes, there's George right there.
Yeah.
So people getting in their picks again here. And while they're doing that, let's see if I think I got another. This is not the Christmas one. This is Rainy Days and Mondays. You mind if I share that?
Please go ahead.
Thank you.
Talking to myself and feeling old. Sometimes I'd like to quit. Nothing ever seems to fit. Hanging around, nothing to do but frown. Rainy days and Mondays always get me down.
Is that one of your favorites by chance?
Yes.
Yeah, it's that's amazing. Wow. I can't wait to see the whole rendition of that, actually. So fantastic. So how many songs do you perform in the Christmas tribute?
Sorry, what was that?
How many songs are you performing in the Christmas tribute?
Probably 15 or more.
It's probably 20 something.
15 or 20. It's over 50% of our Christmas show is holiday music, mm-hmm. and the other 40% is their greatest hits.
Oh, I got you. So it is a mix of, it's not just Christmas songs.
Correct. Yeah. When I first put a Carpenter's Christmas show together back in 2017, shortly before I met Ned. And that first one was just purely Christmas music. But then after doing that, it occurred to me that, you know, the Carpenters Christmas music is wonderful, but to do just do a whole show that's only Carpenters Christmas music and not bring in some of their biggest hits is kind of a missed opportunity. So when we revamped the show, we included their biggest hits.
You have to do Superstar and Top of the World, and we've only just begun State Law. You have to do that. And by the way, we are in the process of finishing up another video that will be for WALE coming up, I guess, maybe in January.
Starting in January.
Yeah, and that will be our main show with all their greatest hits in it.
Yeah, fantastic, fantastic. Yeah. So, yeah, WALE Rocks, WALE.ROCKS, if you want to watch Ken and Sally in their Christmas tribute with the Carpenters. I'm not saying that properly, of course. So, Carpenters Christmas tribute. That's how you want to say it. So, yes.
Yeah, our Christmas show. We chose the title "A Christmas Portrait" because that was the title of their 78 Christmas TV special.
Very nice. Yep. So I'm assuming you have watched that show
many times.
Okay.
I know it. I can recite it in my sleep.
And as an arranger, a lot of their music was never published, and so you can't just go to a music store and buy the sheet music. I had to listen to everything about 200 times and recreate all the music, the horn parts, the guitar.
Oh, my goodness.
This is why you got the job.
Yeah. it's not easy to do. And a lot of it was written while we travel a lot. So you can see on my handwriting, they must have had air turbulence during this
year. That's incredible. So
we put it together. Yeah.
So we're going to wrap up the contest, everybody. So one more minute. If you're just joining us right now, we are giving away the Fire TV Cube. You have to, if you got a new mutt today, what would you name your new mutt in celebration of National Mutt Day? And of course, you know, not that we bring you in here because it is National Mutt Day, but I know you are dog lovers, and it's fantastic that you have taken the time to join us today, Sally and Ken. So really excited, or Ken.
Ned.
Tell who I was talking to. I know you guys. Who you guys know I'm talking about too. Ken Huber. He's not here today. But Sally and Ned. You actually kind of look like Ken. I don't know if anybody's told you that either. But if you get the two of you together sometime, you might be brothers from different mothers as well.
By the way, we want to thank everybody with the kind comments. We're not able to reply, can we reply? I'm not sure we.
Oh my gosh! I guess we know that. Maybe we can. Says chat with host and other guests.
Is that Lanise? Thanks. Yeah. And wow! And Kaylee, yeah. Well, anyway, thanks to all of our fans and for people for tuning in. So
yeah, I agree. I think it's fantastic. You know, if you have any questions, anybody, we have a couple more minutes here. If anybody has any questions for these two lovely people who have decided to join us. And Lola, maybe you have a question for Lola.
She's pretty smart too. She can do math.
Oh, she's hiding.
She's hiding.
Yes.
If you ask her what's 10 minus 10, she'll just stand there and say nothing. So, but anyway, by the way, if they want more information about our show in general, our website is carpenterstributeconcert.com.
CarpentersTributeConcert.com.
And of course, it has links for WALE.ROCKS also. Okay. And they can see where we're performing. Obviously, with the COVID crisis that's happened, we've had a lot of our shows rolled over into 2021.
Right.
We've got shows in Pennsylvania. We've got shows. We're performing, if you have any of your viewers in Texas, we're going to be at the Palace Theater in Grapevine, Texas. That's in the Dallas-Fort Worth area. December 10th and 11th.
Thursday and Friday.
We're doing three shows. And so we were really excited to debut our show last week, which was videotaped so, you know, it can be aired on WALE.ROCKS.
Yes. So you guys are actually going to be back up performing here starting next week.
With a limited audience, of course, with practicing, you know, social distancing, it'll be 50% capacity.
Yeah.
Okay. Are you excited about that?
Very much so. I mean, we've, like Ned said, most of our tour schedule this year had been obliterated, but we've we've had a few opportunities to perform. And of course, these days, any opportunity for us to perform is, we're very grateful for that.
To
have a live audience. It's just, you know, it's live streaming is great, but nothing can replace that energy you get from having real people in the audience.
Yes. Yeah. All right, everybody, the third round is now closed. I'll put that in there so the people who are going to be monitoring this will know. And I'm going to play one more clip from one of your previous shows, and then we're going to ask Google what if Google were to get a pet today, what would Google name it? So all right, so let's see what we have left in the basket here. For let's see, I have clip number 3. I don't think I've
just sing a song. Only yesterday. Don't you remember you told me you loved me, baby? You said you'd be coming back this way again, baby. Baby, 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 oh, baby.
You probably haven't had anybody clap for you for a while either, have you? But next week on December 11th, you will hear applause again.
Yeah.
That's exciting too, right?
Thank you. I want to thank the Academy. Thank you.
Actually, you were able to have a very limited and intimate audience this past Saturday for the debut of our Christmas show here in Las Vegas.
Oh, very nice. So, very nice.
Yeah. A few people, about, I don't know, 30 maybe.
Yeah, we had a couple of our good friends from WALE that were there also. We want to thank them for coming.
Yep.
Very nice. Very nice.
Yeah. George, Ken. Gary, and Ken. Yep. Yeah. Another Ken.
Yes. All these Kens around us here. So yeah. I apologize, Ned, for calling you Ken. I guess I've just been talking to Ken so much lately. And you guys actually look on Ken. It's just unbelievable. So, all right. So I'm going to ask Google now. We'll find out what the great name is. So, okay, Google, can you pick a name for my dog?
Have you considered the name Mushroom?
Mushroom.
Mushroom.
Oh my goodness. I think maybe I should ask one more, right?
Yes.
I don't know if anybody got Mushroom. Okay, Google. Can you pick a name for my dog?
Arrow would be a fun name for a pet.
All right. We got Mushroom and Arrow. We tried to make a determination if anybody got those, that then you'll automatically win, of course. If nobody got that, then we'll try to make a determination as to who.
Maybe the same letter, M or A, right?
There you go. We'll figure that out, right? But we really appreciate everybody participating today. Ned, Sally, thank you again so much for being on here. You can see it scrolling across the bottom. Go to that website. WALE.rocks if you want to watch the Carpenters perform here. So, and I got a couple other shameless plugs to make. We have our page day calendars in too, by the way, now. So these are always the last things to arrive. They are shipping. So anybody who wants to get the page day calendars, they are in stock and shipping now. And of course, we have the world famous National Day calendar printed version. You can order these at nationaldaycalendar.com. And of course, they're everywhere. If you go to your favorite mall or whatever, if you go to the calendar stand, you will find them there too. But you'll probably get a better deal on our website. So go ahead and check that out. And our limited edition Christmas. We're going to have to work something out with this, you guys. Maybe I'll have to talk to the people at WALE Rocks. Maybe we can combine a Christmas special with our ornaments here too, but to celebrate every ornament, there's only 500 of these. They're only $6.99. I'm actually surprised that we're selling them so reasonably, because I know how much work these things take. I don't even know how in the world we can even make any money at this. I need to talk to somebody, I think, about that. But anyway, but they're gorgeous and wonderful on a tree, a great keepsake for everybody that likes to celebrate every day.
All right. A little shameless plug too.
Do that, please.
Carpenters Christmas gifts.
We just launched our online merchandise store. If people go to our website, they go to the store page, then there's a link that will redirect you to our merch store, or you can go there directly. It's carpenterstributeconcert.shop. And our main website is carpenterstributeconcert.com.
You can get t-shirts and mugs and jackets and all kinds of cool stuff. And I believe WALE.rocks is also going to offer a link during our show.
I think so.
I believe so as well.
Okay. So it's carpenterstributeconcert.com.
Right. And then that's our main website. And then the merch site is carpenterstributeconcert.shop.
Okay. Okay. But there's a link if they go to .com, there's a link on there to go to the .shop. Okay. We'll make sure that everybody has those links after the show is over. We'll post those in the comments as well. So, all right, you two, it's been a pleasure. I can't wait to meet you in person, and I'm looking forward to that. Sometime when I'm in Vegas, I'll make sure that I will let you know that I'm there, and we'll go out and do something special. We'll celebrate a national day together or something. How's that sound?
That'd be great.
Yeah. All right, Ned, Sally, Lola, take care. Merry Christmas, you guys.
Bye,
guys.
Merry Christmas, Marlo.
Bye. Say bye, Lola.
Bye.